We are Mars Rover Manipal, a multidisciplinary team of engineering undergraduates from Manipal Academy of Higher Education focused on designing and developing the next generation of Mars rovers. For the past year, our team has been hard at work and I'm proud to present a rover for University Rover Challenge 2018.
Mechanical subsystem is responsible for designing discrete modular subassemblies of the rover based upon the problem statements of the specific individual task. The drive system comprises of a rocket buggy suspension and low pressure balloon tires which have high aspect ratio that allows the rover to have low overall ground pressure. This improves the rover's traction on off-road terrain encountered. The wheel motors are enclosed inside the tire to isolate from any potential obstacles. This year's emphasis was put on the rover's capability, which allows the rover to descend a 1.2 meter ditch at 80 degree grade while holding an object. Our rover consists of a 6 degree freedom articulated robotic arm designed for a payload of 5 kgs. The gripper features two modes of grasp, the power grip, which is used to encompass objects and does not rely on friction alone to constrain the object. It is used to grip heavy objects, precision grip, used to grip small objects and operate elements of the equipment panel with accuracy. This year we have a carbon fiber space frame chassis. The rods of the chassis are made up of cross-linked PVC core reinforced with carbon fiber.
For the 2018 edition of the competition, the electronics and artificial intelligence team focused on long-range reliable communication link and improving the autonomous capabilities of the rover.
Two different frequency bands, 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz, are used to communicate with the rover. A combination of directional and omnidirectional antennas have been used to maximize the range. 24-volt LiPo batteries are used along with voltage converters to power all the onboard components. The NVIDIA Jetson TX1 is used for onboard processing of sensor data as well as implementation of deep learning network for the marker detection. Two ARM-based STM32 microcontrollers are used for precise control of the rover motion as well as data acquisition from the sensors. Fail-safe checks and an emergency stop has been mounted on the rover to ensure safety in case of any irregularities. Custom PCBs have been manufactured to improve modularity as well as to reduce wiring.
In order to prepare for the extreme retrieval and delivery task, the team focused on testing the rover in conditions similar to those at MDRS. We simulated multiple tracks complete with lane markers and specified positions for delivering the objects. The driver has been trained to control the rover with the feedback available only from the cameras on board. This will allow the base station team to be prepared for different kinds of situations expected in the task. Keeping in mind the rigors of this task, we have managed to successfully establish a non-line of sight range up to 800 meters between the rover and the base station. For the equipment servicing task, extra emphasis has been placed on driver training and precision grip of the end effector. A special provision has been provided on the gripper to interact with the keyboard with accuracy. A mock-up panel was designed to simulate the sub-task to be completed for this challenge. This has resulted in the ability to tackle these sub-tasks in a timely and efficient manner. To complete the autonomous traversal task, the rover relies on live GPS coordinates and magnetometer heading to traverse along the shortest path to the destination. On its way, the rover requires data from ultrasonic sensors and a LiDAR to avoid any significant obstacles in its path and reroutes the path once it moves away from the obstacle. Many checks have been included in the program to ensure that the rover is not stuck at any particular location. Once the destination is reached, the rover proceeds to search for the visual marker and utilizes computer vision and deep learning to track the visual marker and follow it until it is within 2 meters of the rover.
The URC 2018 science task is defined to be conducted in a series of in situ and ex situ analysis focused on determining the biosignatures within the bio. For soil collection, an auger drills the soil up to a depth of 10 cm. Then the sensors are inserted into the soil, which measure temperature, humidity, and other parameters. Data from these sensors is transmitted to the control station, which is then used to determine if the given sample is suitable for further laboratory analysis. An airtight soil collector is then used to collect and store the sample.
For the soil and atmospheric analysis, various physicochemical tests have been standardized to determine the ability of the soil to host life. The test focuses on the search for life at cellular, molecular, and elemental level. The team is also involved in the research on astrobiology and Mars missions that has helped with the approach with our task.